Happy New Year, Canada. I can't see the card. Oh, there it is. Howie Mandel.
Hi, I'm Lily Singh.
I'm Trish Stratus.
And I'm Cardinal Official from Canada's Got Talent on City TV.
Looking back on the year that was, we saw some exciting plays, fantastic goals.
Look at that! Are you watching this?
And breathtaking saves.
Oh, did you see that?
There certainly was some talent on display.
Auston Matthews dazzled the league with 41 goals in just 52 games, and it continues this season.
Matthews shoots, scores!
The Cinderella Montreal Canadiens made it all the way to the Stanley Cup Final in an epic run that gave us shades of 1993.
Woo! What a sight that was to see.
The Tampa Bay Lightning showed us they have some amazing talent on ice as they cruised to back-to-back Stanley Cups.
And can you believe the great eight?
Backhand shot, score! Ovechkin all alone in fifth place.
Alex Ovechkin is flying up the all-time goals list.
Ovechkin glides over the golden Brett.
This guy's not stopping until he passes Gretzky.
This season, we saw the introduction of a new franchise into the league with the Seattle Kraken.
But there was no greater talent than Connor McDavid.
McDavid, beautiful move, in on it! What can you say?
And all of the judges were wowed with some of these great plays. What will we see this year? We can't wait to find out.
It all kicks off next on Hockey Night in Canada.
Howie Mandel tweeted out the other day, looking forward to the end of 2020. It feels like it's been 2 years. And that's just a typical example of Howie Mandel. To hear you say Hockey Night in Canada, Howie, fantastic. Lily, Cardinal, Trish, all the cast at Canada's Got Talent, looking forward to the spring and City TV and the return of the show. You see, we've got games from Ontario and the Pacific Northwest. Two great battles, Vancouver Canucks, Seattle Kraken, coming up a little later following the Sens and the Leafs. To you and yours, health and happiness. Good evening. Welcome to Hockey. There's a great shot. Should mention on Sportsnet 1, the Winter Classic is happening. That shot reminds you of that. And here are two great river skaters, Elliot Friedman and Kevin Bieksa.
Speaking of talent, no, I can't even fake it.
Can you even skate?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I've never seen you on skates.
Like circles around you, Kevin. No problem.
You know, speaking of skating circles, and I should mention our connection to the Got Talent is obviously the Britain edition of the show. Darcy Oak was a sensation, yeah. So Scott will host later tonight in Seattle. But the World Juniors, and we're really sorry for the women under 18 and for the World Juniors that there was a cancellation. But Kevin, what a glimpse. Two games. Weren't they unbelievable?
Well, that first game right there and this first goal by Mason McTavish just showed why he played 9 games in the NHL before this. Just a man amongst boys. That little slip move that Barry eluding the referee before he does his celly. We saw so much in two games from a lot of these players. There's a bright future for Canadian hockey.
Happy birthday, Cole Perfetti. You make this pass, but Owen Power.
Owen Power looked great. He's chewing his gum. He's calm, cool, collected. Again, showing he played at the World Championship with men.
You know what I kind of wondered after watching him here is if they go to the Olympics, would they ask if Power wanted to go?
I mean, and Connor Bedard is 16. Would they want him to go? He was sensational in that second game. And same for Kent Johnson, who's a high pick, 5th overall. You know what, you guys, congratulations. It was a glimpse of greatness. You created great relationships. You created great work. You created great memories. So thank you. Lots to look forward to. We'll leave it at that. Let's send it down to Scotiabank Arena and welcome in Kyle Bukauskas. Happy New Year, Kyle.
Ron, same to you. And on the first day of 2022, looking around Scotiabank Arena, seeing the blue tarps that are back, the seats for the most part that are empty, it does give you some eerie flashbacks of January 2021. It's down here in the corner, no doubt a little bit lonely here tonight, but we are fortunate to have a game to watch this evening, which means the players will be called upon once again to provide some joy and entertainment amidst this hollow atmosphere. So that means seeing the magic of a guy like Mitch Marner, who returns to the lineup tonight. Riley, Nylander, Sandin back in the fold as well. For Ottawa, they're dealing with some more players in COVID protocol, unfortunately, but what an opportunity for Tim Stützle, top-line centerman here tonight, and still 2 weeks shy of his 20th birthday. So, even in an empty building, the love affair between a country and a game, to borrow one of your lines, Ron, still remains.
You know what, Kyle, the other amazing thing, you and I always have this synergy. Ted Lasso, have you watched it, Kyle? I don't know if you're still there, but have you seen it? You can't hear
We're me. Working our way through it, yeah.
Oh, good, yeah. It's a fantastic series. Kevin, you enjoy it. The Grinch that stole Christmas.
I couldn't get into
Kurt
it.
Kurt Browning it's, hasn't watched
it's,
it yet.
It's too positive for me, I think.
That's right.
Yellowstone for me.
Oh, yes. Yeah. You see Milan Lucic? Well, yes. You showed it. Ryan Leslie showed it the other night. All right, I'm blithering here. Kevin, what about the Leafs' return?
Well, the Leafs' return, it's almost like a great reset now, almost like training camp where you have too many forwards, and as Ron beat out of Sheldon Keith earlier, Nick Ritchie is the young man out. So this is what the lines look like, and it's a little bit of jostling for position up and down the lineup. Where do you slot in? How big of a role do you have now that everyone's healthy? And it'll be interesting to see. Certainly a lot of depth at the forward position for the Leafs. Elliot, you know, you wanted to mention that Biega was drawn in tonight. Do you want to take that one?
No, you go ahead, bud.
Well, great kid. He was in the Vancouver system. I had a couple training camps with him. Came into the first training camp and beat the chin-up record. Somebody had it on the panel. I'm not sure. It wasn't you.
Definitely was not me.
Not me.
It wasn't Kel either. So, Ron, I don't know.
Hey, I'm ready. Push-ups, you and me at 10 when David's hosting. And you're still working, so I might.
Anyways, the lines are deep, so we'll see where Irwin does tonight.
Elliot.
You know, for Ottawa tonight, Kyle mentioned Stützle. Big opportunity as a number one center. But, you know, I look at guys like Brännström, you know. Look, Brännström got hurt. He goes back down. I don't know when they were expecting him to come back up, but one man's injury or illness is another person's opportunity, right? It's a big opportunity for Brännström tonight. Lassie Thompson. I look at all the, like, this year, I watch Montreal today. It's all about people who aren't expected to play getting an opportunity. You can look at it and say, oh, we're beaten up. We don't have as many people as we want. Instead, you have to look at it like, this is my time to shine. And when I look at guys like Brännström, I say, this has got to be his time to shine.
Are you wearing a gold chain around your turtleneck? Like, I'm just looking at that thing.
No. Chin up, Elliot. Kelly.
Okay, the biggest story for me, that's funny, though. I like that turtleneck, Elliot. But the biggest story for me for Ottawa is the return of Matt Murray. We all know how difficult it's been this year. He went down to Belleville, played two games. By all accounts, he played really, really well. In an ideal world, when you go down for a month, you'd hope that the goaltender plays 7 or 8 games, but that wasn't the case. But I'm cheering for him. I hope he finds that game again that we all fell in love with Pittsburgh. But with the lack of games, it's going to be a real challenge for Matt Murray.
And the empty seats, just to go back to Kyle for a moment, that's how Ted Lasso opens every broadcast. I don't think I made that clear, but none of it was clear. So, Chris, why don't you help us out? Down to Chris Cuthbert and Craig Sims.
Well, Happy New Year, Ron, and even to Kevin, Happy New Year, and to my partner as well. New opportunities, new challenges with a new year, or maybe we should say old challenges, trying to generate energy in an empty building.
Yeah, and this has been the year of adjustments for the players. You heard Kevin talk in the pregame about the routine of every player. You've had to throw out your normal routines and find a way to get your body going. The empty seats don't help. The lack of energy and ambiance in the building will be difficult when you've missed 13 days since your last game for Ottawa, 17 for the Toronto Maple Leafs. You got to focus on yourself, your own body, get your legs moving, get some bodies in there. Kelly talked about Murray coming back in and playing this game. This is a huge challenge for him. And on the other side, you've got a player in Auston Matthews who has just feasted on the Ottawa Senators. Chris, amazingly, 23 goals in his 24 games against the Senators. But here on home ice, that's the real definitive factor. The challenge tonight for Ottawa is make somebody else beat you. In the last 9 home games, 13 goals for Matthews. He's had 4 points in the last 2 home games in each of them, and that'll be the challenge for them. Get your legs moving early, get into this game defensively, and you see a little bit of sloppiness we've seen in the restart here. We'll see probably a little bit of that early on.
Matthews on pace for 60 now, 5 back of Leon Draisaitl for the league lead in goals. Ron?
Chris, enjoyed your tweet the other day of the Grinch, Kevin Bieksa, so I'm waiting for him to tee off on Noah Dobson. I really like that kid, Noah Dobson, for the New York Islanders.
Nothing but good things for him.
Okay.
Watch.
Don't say anything. Here we go. This is overtime. Edmonton gets a point, and that's important. They hadn't won a game and still haven't all year when they give up the first goal, but they do find a point. San Jose's kind of creeping in on them, so they get a point. Kind of disappointing. Their third loss in a row. Noah Dobson's the hero there. And Montreal, poor Montreal, 5D, 16 skaters. Florida Panthers, Jonathan Huberdeau, 8 points in the last two games. He had three assists today. There's the game-winning goal. Frank Petrano's eighth of the year from Sam Reinhart, Owen Tippett. The Florida Panthers defeat Montauban and the Habs 5-2. It's minus 21 degrees in Minnesota tonight. They say it's even colder than Edmonton in 2003, although the wind chill at Edmonton took it to minus 30. St. Louis and Minnesota are playing the Winter Classic this evening, and as mentioned, Jennifer Bottrell's working that broadcast. It's on Sportsnet 1 tonight, if you want to enjoy that. In addition to the Battle of Ontario, the Battle of the Pacific Northwest, a great night of hockey to begin 2022. Happy New Year from all of us here.
Move over and make room. It will be happier. Happy New Year from Toronto, where 2022 begins like 2021 without fans in the stands, but the hope for better things ahead. As the Battle of Ontario renewed on this New Year's Day from Toronto, there's Matt Murray starting for the Senators. The first time he's been in goal since November 24th, following a reset in Belleville. And at the other end, Jack Campbell, who posted the best save percentage among NHL goaltenders in 2021. His last start in Edmonton was his 100th in the NHL, his 50th with the Leafs. There's Tim Stützle, who will center the top line for the Senators. And Mitch Marner, Craig, back in the lineup for the first time since December the 1st. Feels like it's been a year since we did a game. 3 weeks ago, Leafs for their first game in 18 days. The Senators play for the first time in 2 weeks. And Morgan Rielly plays it in behind the Ottawa net. It'll be scooped back to Rielly, and that shot is deflected up onto the netting 20 seconds in.
Well, you talk a lot about opportunities and everybody excited to get back on the ice and get playing. And for the Ottawa Senators on the other side, Tim Stützle's playing his 82nd game. So basically the last game of a real regular season, something he hasn't been able to do because of all the shortages. That'll be an interesting matchup if that continues. And that's one of the challenges of playing that top line role against great players.
Morgan Rielly testing Matt Murray here in the first minute as he comes off COVID protocol as well. Matthews looking for a loose puck in front of the Ottawa net. Nick Holden there, along with Artem Zut, the shutdown pair for Ottawa. Out against the Matthews line as it's flipped down into the Toronto zone. Dylan Gambrell comes out. He'll center a line for Ottawa, along with Zach Sanford and Austin Matthews. A crash line, if you will, for the team that leads the league in hitting. And the first penalty comes in the opening minute.
Just a bit of a bobbled puck there as Brody was trying to make the play, and it actually ends up allowing him to get into this battle here and draw the penalty, keeping the puck alive with his feet. And you can see Sanford, they got each other's arm, and Sanford got his left arm hooked on Brody's, and so a power play opportunity here for a power play that's been red hot for the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Power play goals in their last six games, in fact 11 for 21. As they go to work here in the opening minute with Tavares to take the draw against Gambrell, and John Tavares along the boards in his 900th career game here tonight.
Chris, you always said that early power play is always difficult to get your timing, but how about when you haven't played in a couple of weeks either? It'll be interesting to see how sharp this Leaf power play is early on.
Kiley kicks it back, Marner back on this power play. There's Nylander going to the net, and a pass for Tavares through his skates and back into the Leaf zone. Alex Formanton on the ice, a couple of shorthanded goals out in a penalty killing role along with Connor Brown. A stretch pass onto the right side for Nylander, drops it back for Marner. Tavares in the slot, but it comes back to Nylander. And now they'll get into position as Matthews has the puck. Nylander across, and Rasmus Sandin with Nylander sending that to an open wing. Bunted to the line for Matthews. Back to Tavares. Rink wide it goes, and that shot wide of the net, looking maybe for a tip for Tavares in front.
Well, there's your timing there. There's two examples of overpassing and thinking that Matthews is going to be in a position that he wasn't.
and just a little bit rusty here to start, and that's expected.
Here comes William McKeon on the second unit and gets the shot on Murray, who will cover up with 43 seconds left. Yeah, in the Sanford penalty.
You ask any of the top players, it is always difficult. Your game isn't quite there yet at the start, and there's Marner thinking that he's got that time. Tavares on the back door. One thing you can do is Ilya Mikheyev in his second game back is use his speed to the outside. That creates a chance and a good save by Murray.
Jason Spezza wins the draw, comes back to the point, and now Mikheyev watched by Brännström. And the puck out of play, another faceoff in the Senators' zone.
Well, boy, another guy who's pretty excited to get back on the ice is Jason Spezza, who was getting prepared to play in Vancouver with his suspension gone from 6-4. You could see the power play, just how effective it's been. All time for Leafs, it's right on the top with 52 games to go in this season.
2-for-8 against Ottawa this year as these two teams split games in the first week of the regular season. Spezza tries to drop it back, that hit the official, be played outside the line, back in by Sandin, offside call.
You talk a lot about the Senators and growth, you know, a rough start, and then they've kind of got their traction, had a good little run before they were halted, and one of the keys has been on the penalty kill. Just one power play goal against in the last six games at 94.7. That's best in the National Hockey League during that stretch, and one of the reasons why they've been competitive in the last 8 or 9 games.
Here's McKeon firing it. Good stop there by Murray. Around for Spezza. Senators 23rd on the kill. Coming into the game as they've moved up with that 19 of the last 20. Sandin trying to drop it back. Broken up by Formanson. Connor Brown out at center ice. Stopped by McKeon. Penalty done. Leafs back in. And Spezza's shot off a stick wide. Here's Michael Bunting. Hit by Sanford along the boards behind the Ottawa net, and the Senators come away with the puck. Artem Suk, who scored his first NHL goal in this building last year, plays it ahead at the Leaf line, knocked down there by Travis Dermott, and offside is called.
Well, you heard Kelly Rudy cheering for Matt Murray, hoping that he could get some traction, get something going. Always difficult right to start a game. You have to kill a penalty, and here Bunting does a nice job of attacking with that puck. Mikheyev gets some open ice, and good aggressive positional save there by Murray on the top end of his blue paint, and able to get the pad out and make the save.
That early power play for Toronto got Sheldon Keefe out of the rolling of everybody to get into the game, and now they've got Simmons with Kemp and Engvall to now have all skaters for the Leafs on the ice, and DJ Smith trying to do likewise for the Senators, but he's got the Stützle line back out as TJ Brody had some trouble with that, got it away from Batherson, and the Leafs back in. Riley will chip it down. There's Stützle behind the net. He lost it to Engvall. Here Engvall trying to turn away from Thomas Chabot. And Victor Mete's on it. The former London Knight will stride out two centers. He'll flip it down into the Leaf zone, and it'll be gloved by Campbell with Alex Viega in the vicinity. Well, don't miss the new CBC original comedy about growing up in the 1980s. Son of a Cringe, coming this January to CBC and CBC Jam. So Alex Viega makes his Leaf debut here.
And for now, anyways, pairing with Dermott. So again, another combination that you have to find some comfort with as players and get to know where your partner's gonna be on the ice.
So two former captains of Harvard on the ice at the same time for Toronto. Both Viega and Alex Kerfoot had that distinction. Puck taken away and back up the ice, Clark Bishop, but we've got another penalty against Ottawa.
Another little hook as Nylander trying to make a play, and there's Sir Adam Gaudette back in the lineup here, just gets the stick into the hands. Nylander kind of got his legs tied up there, but once you get your stick in there, you know that the referees are sensitive to that, so I'm not sure that Gaudette was actually the one that knocked him down, but the hands, stick in the hands, draws another power play opportunity. Pretty pedestrian first power play for the Leafs. See what they can do in the second.
Power play brought to you by Kit Kat Chunky, made for hunger.
Ambrell will get Wade. Austin Watson to take the draw for Ottawa. And from the draw, Ambrell out in center ice, and he'll go to the attack. Mitch Marner defensively as Gambrell takes it down below the goal line, and now the Leafs will get organized. And Morgan Riley will start them in the right direction and kick it back to Matthews. 8 power play goals, 15 points across to Nylander, who has 14 power play points. And Nylander to the middle of the ice, doesn't shoot. A stick on it by Gambrell to turn the Leafs back.
Yeah, initially it looked like he had Tavares and was thinking pass, and then the lane got taken away, and then that little delay allowed a good stick by the penalty kill to turn that puck over and send him all the way back down.
Now Matthews to work over the line with Tavares. Nice move there by Tavares, then lost the handle, and it'll be turned back by Brown. Gamble does some stick handling and swings it across for Morgan Riley, with Alex Formanton out along with Brown.
And Formanton in his last game in Philadelphia scored a nice shorthanded goal there, so there's always the threat of that for Ottawa as well.
There's Mikheyev speeding in. It comes around for Spezza. Former Senator across, Mikheyev right on. Rebound collected by Kasha. Oh, Mikheyev, just his second game, waited 2 months to play his first. That was in Edmonton, the Leafs' last game 18 days ago. Sandin moves it quickly. That goes off the stick of Branstrom, popped out in front. Rasmus Sandin fired, and that was muffled by Brown. Sent wide across for Mikheyev. Up high, it's Kasha. Checked there by Formanton. And Brown wins a battle to get it outside the line. 9 seconds of the second Leaf power play. Slick move by Sandin. Here's Bunting on the backhand in front. And Matt Murray with a nice stop off Spezza in front. So the Leafs 0 for 2 on the power play. 6:23 in, and Matt Murray has made 5 stops early for the Senators.
Skip the dishes, order all your game time favorites now. Everyone was doing their own year in review the last few days. Austin Matthews, 2021, among the most impressive. 61 goals, 43 of them at even strength, 16 game winners on 343 shots. He led the league in all of those categories and did it over just 79 games. And as Kevin mentioned in the pregame show, Chris, he's been one of the best players without the puck this season as well.
99 points for Austin Matthews in 2021.
When you think of the frustration, right now he's on a 10-game point streak, 13 goals in that little stretch. Now all of a sudden you miss another 3 weeks. You don't skate for 10 days. It kind of gets you out of your rhythm. And a couple of years ago, 47 goals, 3 away from getting his first 50-year, and then the season canceled, basically, the regular season. So lots of adjustments to be made.
Here's Sandin trying to play it in front of the net off the stick of Tierney, and out comes Connor Brown, who played his first 3 years with the Leafs, trying to get around Sandin with Tierney and Formanton. And Justin Hall steers it back to Sandin. That pairing tonight in the absence of Jake Muzzin. There's Shabbat. Pounded by Engvall, stepping in front of that pass was Biega, and Engvall's back in, trying to split the D. Matthews following, and a loose puck slides wide of the net. Engvall couldn't find it in his skates. Tierney tried to play it up the boards. Batherson denied by Matthews on that first clearing attempt. Now it'll come around to Drake Batherson, who led the Senators in scoring in 2021 with 62 points. Up the hit, the pass cut off by Tkachuk. Here's the captain back in, Brady Tkachuk. 18 points in 18 games since being given the C. Along the board, Stützle, now Mete. That shot blocked in front. Puck is loose, and Biega had some trouble with that. Senators looking for their first shot on goal. Here's a centering pass by Tkachuk. Sprawling there was Marner, trying to get it out. Kept in by Batherson. Here's Tkachuk looking to center and bunting there defensively to take it away from Stützle. And Marner out at center plays it to the Ottawa line. 8 minutes into this opening period. Tavares checks in along with Kerfoot to Nylander.
Here's Tavares behind the net. Morgan Riley across. Brody's shot with wide rebound. Another good stop there by Murray off Nylander. Off the glove of Tavares, so Nylander can't play that puck. Gambrell and Sanford sending it across, and here's Austin Watson on his off wing. Leg it in front of the Leaf net. Watson giving chase against TJ Brody. Nylander along the boards, locked down by Sanford, and he'll play it back in. In Philadelphia 2 weeks ago, the Flyers had the first 13 shots on goal before Ottawa got going. That one ended up going to overtime before the Flyers prevailed. Back to the line. Here's Biega shooting it wide. Sandin moves up. Backing it up is Camp. McCabe, who already has 3 shots on goal, spins it back to Sandin in the slot for Camp. Knocked off his stick. And the Senators off the glass and out. Here's Logan Shaw playing it to the far side. Alex Biega off Pasha's stick and deep as both teams make changes. Here's Eric Branstrom back for the first time since late November after suffering a broken hand. Travis Dermott trying to chop that away. Puck comes out in front. And Brody there for Toronto. Taken away by Brown. Wayne Simmons after it, ran into Branstrom. The puck slides out to center ice. Engvall in pursuit of the puck. Sends it across to Simmons, and here's Spezza firing it. And a glove stopped by Murray, who's had a confident start to this return to action. So just past the midway mark of this opening period, here's Jason Spezza with the latest Leaf chance. Captain, and we've already seen evidence tonight, Simmer, of him kind of taking charge out there.
Well, one of the things that you have to build is a rapport with the officials. This is after 2 penalties against Ottawa in the first 4 minutes. You're not going over being demonstrative. You're just calmly having a little discussion. And I think that's a really important factor. You got to show your team that you've got some control in the game. You got to show the officials you're not being irrational. You're not being emotional. You just say, hey, okay, if that's the standard, let's make sure it continues that way. That's part of the challenge of being a young captain. And that was well done.
His first game against Toronto this year. The 2 early games had him just getting back and signed with the Senators. Bunting plays it around to the near side for Matthews. Tried to chip it to Marner. And there is Stützle. Took advantage of the break to go back home and celebrate Christmas in Germany. That one knocked down there, and a good stick by Batherson. At the line, Batherson looked like he was peeling off to the bench on a change, but sends it toward the net, loose in front, and that one cleared away from the front of the goal with Zach Sanford on the porch.
I don't think Campbell had any idea where that puck popped up to, but Riley did a good job of calmly getting down and clearing in front of the net.
And that will officially be the first shot on goal for Ottawa on the night. Gambrell knocked it off the stick of Tavares. Kerfoot trying to team a bouncing puck. Nick Holden moves it, and Austin Watson flipped it ahead, knocked down by Tavares. Keeps it in and swings it back along the corner boards. It comes to Sandin, and now Hall returns it for Rasmus Sandin. Great pass in front. Nylander tried to get it to Tavares, and he was well covered in front. Pass gets by Sandin, and the Senators able to move it out. A couple of times we've seen Nylander defer early.
Yeah, I think if he had that one back, you make that shot, and maybe if there is a rebound, Tavares could be on the doorstep to get it. But great play by Sandin with his head up, made an excellent pass through the seam.
Dustin Hall redlining in. Matt Murray out of the net quickly to knock that one down. Sends it around the boards. McKeon checked it. Out comes the speedy Formington. Tierney at the line. Got checked there by McKeon, who came back. And Travis Dermott, under 8 to go here in the first period. 8-1. Shots on goal favor the Leafs, who had 2 early power play opportunities. There's Thomas Chabot Talked about that Philadelphia game. Shabbat playing 37 minutes and 50 seconds in that game. That's the most by any player in a regular season game since the 2014-15 season. Here's Simmons sending it in, and Engvall on the move. Trying to come up with that puck. Simmons follows in. And after it in the corner. Played back to the line for Riley. Knocked down by Simmons in front. And a sprawling defensive play there. A block there by Stützle in front. Stützle may have saved the goal there, and now Branstrom ahead, and it rolls to Campbell, who spins it back to TJ Brody. Brody, who scored his first of the season in Edmonton in a 5-1 Leafs win in their last game, their 20th win of the year in 30 starts. Here's Bunting on that left side, fanned on the pass. He's taken out by Zub. Holden stepped into Matthews. And now Batherson. Holden on to the right side for Bishop. Knocked down by Riley. And Ottawa's going to get his first power play of the night on a cross-checking call against Morgan Riley.
JackpotCity.net. Casino games perfectly made for you.
Well, there's a perfect example of it. Just a little cross check there, but look at the reaction of Morgan Riley right in front of the official. And that's what I mentioned about Brady Tkachuk going over and just having a little discussion, a couple of calls both ways, and a power play here that was 0 for 3 in the last two, but it's been much better as well. 5 for 13 in the previous three games, and here a chance to get the game's first goal does the Senators power play.
2 for 6 against Toronto in the first two meetings of the year, but without Josh Norris, who leads Ottawa in power play goals with 5. Camp after that puck out in a penalty killing role with Mitch Marner, who is back in the lineup, and that means back on the penalty kill. So with Mikheyev and Marner, here comes Batherson steaming in, and he held up there and didn't get a good shot away, and back comes Camp. Moving up on the play is Hall. It's a 2-on-1. Justin Hall scores. Short-handed. And Hall has his first of the year.
Well, first in 47 games for Hall. He's got tissue in his nose. He obviously got hit early on. But as you see so often, a chance at one end doesn't materialize. You get an opportunity at the other. How about TJ Brody? Just all in, gets the stick out, keeps it flat against the ground, even looking the other way, but he makes the play. Now you've got in the middle, Stützle's got a foot race going here with Hall. Hall wins the battle, and that one slides underneath, as you can see Murray trying to slide her up cross in desperation. David Camp is looking past the entire way. Never really even looked at Murray. A perfect pass, a quick shot underneath, and something doesn't happen often. Hall gets another one here, his first in 47, to make it a 1-0 game.
First shorthanded goal given up by the Senators this year, 14:06. Time of the goal, and now Kerfoot up ahead. Mikheyev got a step on Lassie. Thompson scores! Two shorthanded goals in rapid fire.
Well, you've said it early on. Mikheyev, in just his second game, has had his legs the entire start of this period. Of all players, he's been able to create some separation. Look at the four white sweaters in deep. Now you got Chris Tierney. He goes and forces Kerfoot. That creates the space to the outside, and there's just an excellent job of getting that open lane, keeping your legs moving, making sure you got the Lassie Thompson out of the way, and this one underneath the arm on Murray. You can see Murray was backing up. So often it's been Mikheyev getting those shorthanded chances and unable to finish it off. There, in just his second game back, he gets one shorthanded.
19 shots on goal shorthanded last year without a goal, but 27 seconds after the Hall goal, and the Leafs looking for more, but that time the Kasha pass broken up, and Ottawa gets pointed in the right direction. 40 seconds remaining in a power play that has been disastrous for Ottawa. Here's Shabbat sending it across. Now Ottawa trying to get it set up. Back to Shabbat again. Stutzel's on this near side. Batherson on the other flank in front for Tkachuk, and he couldn't pull the trigger. And it comes to the line and back out. Pass for Stützle off his stick, and
Swung back there by Dermott.
Now what a play for Mikheyev, though. So often, even Sheldon Keefe has said, if he can get that calmness by the net, you know, he creates so much with his speed, and there was a perfect example of it. No hesitation, and that one finds its way in the back of the net.
Zuba head over the line, Austin Watson. Steered away by Campbell, the Leafs back at full strength. And John Tavares tries to work his way out through center. Here's Tavares to the Ottawa line. Engvall goes after that against Zub. So again, the shorthanded goals come 27 seconds apart. And the Leafs with a 2-0 lead. Sandin's shot is knocked down in front. That hits Zub. Clearing attempt popped up into the air, kept in by Hall. Engvall for Kerfoot on this left side. Now it's Tavares trying to get it back to Kerfoot. And Watson intercepts for the Senators and rolls it into the Leaf zone. 3:33 left here in the opening period. And Nylander, a give and go play that was intercepted. Adam Gaudette back in his own zone. And now out comes Mete, a lead feed to the line. It comes to Clark Bishop, and he whipped it high. There's Shabbat trying to swing it back in. DJ Brody's got that. Here comes Brody over the line. Nylander spun around there and knocked down. Matthews able to play it back in deep. Shabbat getting away from Marner. Flipping it down into the Leaf zone from his side of center, and that's an icing call against Ottawa. And now a message from the Chevrolet Good Deeds Cup.
This year, let's make room on the bench. Shift change in your community. Visit ChevroletGoodDeedsCup.ca to find out more.
Last time the Leafs scored two shorthanded goals in a game, October 30th of 2015 in Calgary. 2013. And Justin Hall and Ilya Mikheyev have done it here in the opening period. In 2022, Alex Formanton on the move. Send it rink wide. Matthews there, watched by Tierney. Zub at his own line across for Holden. And now chopped in by Connor Brown. Formanton shot, and a sprawling block there. Now this Dermott. Matthews starts out. Here's Matthews on the line, trying to slide it through. And that pass broken up as Jason Spezza was on the move. On the boards, Stützle plays it across. A centering pass knocked down in front as Brody had tied up Brady Tkachuk. There's a big hit by Stützle as the puck sit down into the Ottawa zone, icing the call.
Well, there's Tim Stützle, did a pretty good job of coming back on that one play, got a good stick in there, and you know, this is the challenge of no Pinto, no Norris. Now you're in a greater role, just 14 days away from his 20th birthday, and this is one of those matchups that is a difficult one.
Tkachuk taking the draw there, but the Leafs able to work it out. Lassie Thompson added to the lineup today when Jacob Bernard-Docker was the latest Ottawa Senator to be put into COVID protocol. Over the line come the Leafs again. It's Kasha swinging it to Mikheyev, who's been prominent here in the opening period in front. And a pad stop there by Murray off Kasha. But the Leafs take the early advantage on an Ottawa power play. First Hall and then Mikheyev, both scoring shorthanded.
As captain of the Maple Leafs, the father of two now, writes the names of his boys, Jason Axton, near the top of his stick. The birth dates on the back, a little dose of perspective, he says, during the game whenever he looks at them. He's the first to admit he doesn't have all the answers in his role. He's not much for New Year's resolutions, but he still leans on those around him when it comes to his approach within the organization. Chris.
Next point for John Tavares will move him one ahead of Ted Lindsay on the all-time scoring list.
Didn't make it anywhere near midnight, he said last night. Two young kids waking up early in the morning.
I don't have two young kids, but I can relate.
You didn't make it either, did you?
I didn't.
Two shorthanded goals in the first period. Jason Murdoch, our ace statistician, bringing it early in 2022. The last time the Leafs did that in the first period of a game, 1963, Dave Keon, Ron Stewart. There's Connor Brown centering. Here's Shabatian. Thomas Shabbat trying to bank it in. And that went off the back of Campbell and out the other side. Coach call for the Senators here in the final minute. Campbell will be kept in at the line and fired right on Campbell, who will hold on. Follow all the action during Beijing 2022 and everything leading up to it. Download the CBC Sports app today.
It has been a very busy period for Jack Campbell, but here he has to make a quick decision, and he comes aggressive here as Shabbat goes to the side. He's all in and then does a heck of a job of lifting his pads up and making sure that the back of his leg doesn't knock the puck into his own net. That was a difficult play and a tough read looking behind it.
Morgan Riley gets control. Little flip into the Ottawa zone. McKayev trying to skate onto it. Beaten to the puck there by Zub. And Brady Tkachuk sends it onto the right side. Riley got there to send it away from Batherson.
Brazilian McKayev looks like he doesn't want to come out of the lineup. As we heard Sheldon Keefe saying, he had to make a healthy scratch for the first time of a forward. And McKayev has taken notice in his second game. He's been effective.
Absolutely. The speed has been noticeable, and the finish something he's been looking for. And the horn sounds to end the opening period. The shots on goal, 11-4 in favor of Toronto. Justin Hall, Ilya Mikheyev, shorthanded goals 27 seconds apart. And the Leafs have a 2-0 lead after one period of play. Our first intermission with Ron McLean coming up after this.
Dennis Vial played the majority of his NHL career with the Senators. He is the uncle of current Sen, Drake Batherson. He was an intimidating defenseman back then. Christmas Day, however, decided to put on the pads for a game of shinny on the Batherson pond. The only condition was, he said, tennis balls only when shooting on me. And he got a glimpse of why his nephew has 9 goals on the season. A few times he turned to Drake's dad, Norm, after a shot and asked, did that go in? He didn't even see it, Chris.
Much different player than Uncle Dennis is the former Valley Wildcat, Drake Batherson. And he and the Senators looking for a better second period. Outshot 11-4, the shot attempts 23-6 in the opening 20.
Yeah, it's amazing what a period can go awry in 27 seconds when you're thinking power play to get your first. And they're going to have to put that one behind and try to regroup and get back into this game.
Leafs win the opening faceoff. They won 15 of 19 draws in the first period of play. Zoom. Now Marner takes over for the Leafs. Got it to Matthews. It's sent across for Brody and back to Morgan Riley. Finds Matthews and he one times that wide. Another shot off the flank by Riley. And Matt Murray seems surprised by that.
Well, that was, yeah, just a great move by Riley. Just sliding down the boards, and that puck came quickly back, and he put it right back on net.
Here's Marner back in. Mitch Marner deep and is tripped up behind the net. Another penalty coming as Campbell goes to the Leaf bench for an extra attacker. Nylander comes on, but the puck is touched, and the Leafs get a power play in the opening minute of this second period with Nick Holden heading off.
Well, Chris, here's that matchup I said. You've got Stützle's line up against Matthews, and right here from the beginning, great puck movement side to side, and look to see a little late reaction from Murray, not sure where that puck was. Now the delay here by Marner, and this is just Holden with the stick. It's right on the skate blade as Marner's trying to buy himself a little time. Holden already committed. There wasn't much he could do. Tried to get puck and instead got skate.
So Tavares wins the faceoff to get this Leaf power play started. The crossing comes to Marner. Marner swung it in the direction of Tavares. Back for Riley. Gambrell on the kill. Matthews in, knocked off his stick. Kept alive at the line by Riley. Back to Matthews, finds Marner shooting, and that hit traffic in front. Not sure if that didn't go off. John Tavares in front. Here's Matthews. Down low, it's broken up by Mete. Matthews gets it back. Riley back for Matthews. Here's Marner in front, and Tavares couldn't reach that. Might have been disrupted there by Mete in front. Matthews loses the puck, but gets it back. And the Leafs continue to control in the Ottawa zone. Here's Marner trying to break a long power play goal drought. Matthews fires, and that's off target, and it will wrap around to the right point, kept in by Riley. Matthews, another look, and that one is blocked by Mete. Morgan Riley again. Ottawa can't get a clear. William Nylander up high. And a crisscross with Marner. Back from Matthews, shooting that, and it deflected up onto the screen and out of play.
Well, what a difference between the early power play in period one compared to this one here in period two. Marner looks like he's going to shoot. Got the defenseman down, and look at Murray. Just a little bit of that off the stick as Tavares was right on the doorstep, ready to tap that one in. A pretty good read by the Ottawa goaltender to get just enough of that. And you can see the reaction as Tavares was watching it on the big screen.
So 42 seconds remaining. And another faceoff win by the Leafs. Off Svensson. That one centered. Mikheyev will swing it back. Bunting unable to deflect that in front of the net as Spezza plays it back to the line for Sandin. Gets it back again. Rasmus Sandin sizes it up, takes the shot, and that ends up on the netting.
Well, much like the first, it's an onslaught here for Murray, and you know, I thought it was a pretty solid first period except for that 27 seconds and those two quick chances he wasn't able to get a piece of, but you got to just draw on your experiences. He spent the month, as they were saying, down in the AHL, but because of all the cancellations, only two games. So you just back under the fire and got to settle yourself down and keep competing.
Spezza feeds the point. Good keep in at the line by Kasha. Here's Kasha. Bunting. Point for Sandin. Now it's Ilya Mikheyev. Quickly move to Kasha. Back to Mikheyev. Sandin with the penalty done. That's kicked away by Murray as Holden has returned to the ice. Bunting from the corner tried to come out in front and was checked on the play there. Sent back in. Spezza gets it back from Sandin. Sidestep Zub. There's Jason Spezza turning back away from Connor Brown. Mikheyev's on it again. Gets it to Hall. And now Sandin back to Justin Hall, and he fired that, and deflecting off Brown's stick and out.
Now Hall looking for his second of the game, and you see no longer the tissues in the nose. This, you saw Ron show it earlier. Man, this was scary. This could have been a whole lot worse. Man, as Sandin's blade hits him right on the side of the face, gets it all plugged up, and then what a heads-up play to jump up. David Kampf with the nice pass, and that started the shorthanded onslaught as Hall, really aggressive on that kill, jumped up and joined the play to make it a two-on-one.
New partnership there in the absence of Muzzin tonight as they go over the last sequence. Puck out at center, but Engvall plays it back down into the Ottawa zone.
And this pair has looked okay too. Viega getting his opportunity with Dermott. They've looked pretty comfortable so far, haven't got themselves in too much trouble.
Viega, veteran, 33 years of age. In his eighth year, Vancouver and Detroit. Here comes Formanton, and that shot turned aside by Campbell. Nice burst by Formanton, and back the other way comes Camp. Travis Dermott with another penalty upcoming against the Senators. And an extra attacker comes on once again. Simmons checked by Tierney. And the Leafs will go to their fourth power play of the game.
And really a chance for Formanton to really give a little spark after the penalty kill. Watch what speed does here. Starts from a standstill, does a nice job of curling to his right, and then gets his legs going, creates a little separation. But Jack Campbell out aggressively. Sanford here absorbs one hit. Oh, a little retaliation, and Simmons been hit a lot worse than that. There's the retaliation that goes in. So back to back, much like the first period, it's almost exactly the same and almost the exact same timing. Two early power plays for the Leafs.
On the draw, the Leafs prevail, and it's Riley for Marner. Back to Morgan. Riley shooting, and that just went wide with heavy traffic in front of Matt Murray. Matthews to the line. Riley's 8 points in his last four games. Across from Marner, walking in, and Matt Murray's got that short side. Well, don't miss the new comedy run, The Burb, starring Andrew Fung from Kim's Convenience. Coming this January on CBC and CBC Gym, Run the Burbs.
The puck keeps finding its way over to Marner on his strong side. Matthews with the no-look back pass. Riley tries to open up the lane for Marner. You can see Marner take a quick look to see if there's any passing lane and then tried to go short side up top, but Murray able to stay up and make the save.
February 3rd, 2020, the last time Mitch Marner scored a power play goal. Hasn't in the last 98 games. Matthews. Riley gives it back to Matthews. That pass off a stick, and it's a two-on-one the other way. Connor Brown with Tierney. Here's Brown firing it, and he just missed. Close call there. Now Matthews gathers speed through center. Marner with the man, Tavares. Mitch Marner in, sliding it through. And Tavares got kind of caught up there in the wash with Matthews. Back the other way, a three-on-two Ottawa. It's Brännström, backhand, and that went wide. Mente up there, both defensemen. Now Forbenton, and that's kicked away off the toe of Jack Gamble. So Ottawa comes close to a shorthanded goal. Nylander starts back. Here's Tavares in, and that's turned aside by Murray. Marner the rebound. Matthews in front, stop rebound. Back-to-back saves for Matt Murray.
Well, that's about 35 seconds of just trading chances end-to-end. You can see Matthews with the loop there creates the two-on-one. Nice job of Morgan Riley. Deliver the shooter to your goaltender. You got faith in Campbell. And here's the little collision between Tavares. He gets tied up with Matthews. That creates another chance at the other end. Three-on-two. Jack Campbell never even had to make that stop. And then Murray with two good ones at the other end as Matthews was point-blank twice, and Murray able to shut the door and hold on.
34 seconds remaining in this latest Leaf power play. 0-for-3 in the game. Spezza across, and that will bring the Leafs back out to re-rack at center. And Sandin sends it back in. Spezza first after it. Caught Bunting by surprise with that drop, and Austin Watson the other way. Leans into McKayev and knocks him to the ice.
You know, the message for DJ Smith has to be now, stay out of the box. You got to get your lines together and get going, get a little momentum. It's been a tough coaching battle. Shorthanded already, losing two of your top centermen, and now you're forced to play your penalty killers. Demand a lot on them.
And right from the get-go in both the first and the second period. Here's Wayne Simmons. Watched by Stützle. Around it comes to TJ Brody. Brody sends it toward the net, and Murray will hold on. So the Leafs 0-for-4 on the power play, but leading on the strength of two shorthanded goals.
Stops and starts for Matt Murray, from the unknown illness to a concussion and then COVID protocol. And when the results weren't there in between, you can understand why his confidence was a little shaken when he was put on waivers and sent to the minors at the end of November. The word from Belleville was, however, attitude great from the jump, and like everyone else down there, just trying to earn a call. Gave up two in the first. He's been holding down the fort here in the second, Chris.
Worked with Justin Peters in Belleville. And the hope was to get him a lot of action, but unfortunately, COVID hit the Belleville Senators as well. So just the two games, 1-1 was his record in the American Hockey League. There's another Leaf faceoff win, a shot by Nylander after double clutching. It'll come back to Nylander again. And it comes outside the line, a lead pass here for Sanford. Zach Sanford trying to cut to the net. Jesper Sandin stepped into him. Victor Mete at the point. Across to Shabbat, walking in. And that went off ball and went wide of the net. There's ball, hit manning the puck. Kerfoot spinning it to Tavares. That shot deflecting wide of the net. Kerfoot for Tavares. Shabbat's lost his stick in coverage there against the Leaf captain. And it'll come back to Brody.
And Riley shooting it right on the rebound. Here is Brody, a wraparound score by T.J. Brody.
What a read by Brody to jump down, and coming off his first goal in 46, the last game he gets two in two games. But at the other end, this is a glorious chance by Shabbat, hit the back of the skate of Hall, never even made it into Campbell. And Kerfoot with some patience there. Brody makes the pass, but then continues down. And you can see Murray gets tied up with Shabbat. His own players battling with John Tavares in front. And watch Shabbat, he doesn't have his hand on his stick. He pushes his goalie to the other side. And Brody on the backhand, a bit of a difficult play, goes off the skate of Stützle and stuffs that in the open side for a 3-0 lead.
One goal all of last year, and his first in 46 in Edmonton 18 days ago, and now Brody scored in back-to-back, and it's 3-0 Toronto.
I don't think you would have been thinking that for T.J. Brody, the back-to-back games on a scoring streak.
Stützle over skates it and then just shovels it in on the backhand. Brody from Chatham. And we want to have a little shout out to Chatham because they've named all their snowplows, and one of the snowplows is named Flirty Plow, which I think deserves a little mention on Hockey Night in Canada. Here comes Brown, back the other way. Trying to work his way against Biega. Tierney to the line. And that pass will pull Brännström out to center ice. Mete for Tierney, and it's scooped back into the Leaf zone. Ottawa looking for a response here. Brännström moves up, unable to get that directed towards the net, but following up, it's Gambrell in behind the net. Trying to twist away from the track of Brown, and Diego works him over, and David Camp comes away with it. Quickly, the Leafs move it through center, and it's Marner going to steer it down to get a change. David Camp on the forecheck as Brännström plays it to Lasse Thompson. Here's Thompson ahead for Watson, and Ottawa able to work its way out, but Formanton and Brännström got cut off there. And Mikheyev back in for Ottawa, or for the Leafs, into the Ottawa zone.
Another example of Mikheyev using his speed, as Elliot said, the most notable that this time off and all the training he was able to do and anticipating getting back, he looks, he's taken full advantage of.
Here's Sandin, red line and in. Again, Sandin playing for the first time since December 5th when he had that knee-on-knee collision with Neil Pionk in Winnipeg. Shot down by Gaudette, and Campbell quickly plays it to Brody, a lead feed. That's Eggball in behind everybody and stopped by Murray. Eggball had to wait for that and didn't have a lot of momentum, but a breakaway stop by Matt Murray on the latest Leaf chance.
You know, as a veteran player, you always say, okay, when I get my chance, this is what I have to do. Well, this has been, as Elliot was mentioning, a year where it was an important one for Mikheyev. He's had the frustration of the injury last year, the injury to start the season, but here in just his second game, there's the shorthanded chance, and he's been a hound on the puck. And that's exactly why Kyle Dubas was saying, I'm not looking to make a trade. That's a value. That kind of speed and that kind of size and the ability to penalty kill makes him a valuable piece of the chess set.
Well, they thought he had a terrific preseason and then broke his thumb in the final game of the preseason. But until that point, the discussion was, are they going to play him in the top six?
You know, you always have to have those versatile pieces when guys go down or maybe they're on a little bit of a slump, somebody who can slot in. And because of that speed and size and ability to play in all situations, he's a valuable piece for Sheldon Keefe. I think that's why Nick Ritchie is the one who right now anyways will be the healthy scratch. So he's some good competition going forward here with healthy forwards.
Past the midway mark of the second period, here's Kerfoot speeding in, put on the brakes, and a centering pass. Tavares was covered on the play. Nylander back to Hall. William Nylander's got it again. Centering pass, it went off Kerfoot with Rasmus Sandin moving in, and now Ottawa on the counter. St. John's Newfoundland native Clark Bishop plays it in behind the Leaf net.
Perfect, might have saved the goal there. He actually didn't see that he had Sandin on the back door. Might have been a tap-in had he let that one go.
And Matthews taken to the boards by Shabbat, but stays on the puck. Gets knocked to his knees, stays on the puck. Back to Sandin and Hall. Hall sends it to the net, traffic in front, kicked loose by Butkin, but Ottawa able to clear. Pace seems to have quickened here in the second period.
I mentioned before for DJ Smith, the start of this period, having all your guys killing penalties, get your bench out of rhythm, and now they got to find a way to get a little bit of momentum back in the offensive zone.
Quick counter here, and Tkachuk shot off the stick of Viega and out of play. 3-0 Maple Leafs, 8:35 left here in the second period on Hockey Night in Canada.
Some friends and family sprinkled throughout Scotiabank Arena tonight. However, there's at least one super fan in the house. That's Curtis Stevenson on the right from Redcliffe, Alberta. You may have seen the visuals of his Leafs man cave on social media. It is impressive. Over 350 pieces. He estimates it's all worth around $100,000. He's a guest of MLSE tonight. It's something that's been in the works for a while now. He had to deal with canceled flights and icy roads to get here, but he made it, and surely he's enjoying what he has seen so far, Chris.
Boy, a super fan indeed. Thinking of all the disappointed fans that couldn't be at these holiday games, and imagine what the anticipation of having tickets for Wednesday with Connor McDavid here, but not going to be able to be. There's a chance for Foreman to the front. Oh, what a stop! How did that stay out? And Campbell is down. And did TJ Brody save a goal after scoring one to make it 3-0?
Well, Brody's got 3 points in the night, and I think he just got another one if you count this save here. As Campbell's all in, tried for the poke check, and yeah, good battle. But how about Campbell pushing himself back with his glove? He does a good job here of trying to get a piece of it, misses, gets the stick of Brody and then the toe of Campbell. And as he's falling back, look at how he pushes himself out to make sure. There's the toe save. Brody gets another couple of whacks at it. Brown can't believe that one didn't end up in the back of the net. Brody's first assist was looking the opposite way and getting his stick down and stopping a pass. There, his stick saved another one. Would have made it an interesting game.
Brody came into the game with 7 points. He has a goal and 2 assists tonight. Alex Kerfoot's got a pair of points. Tkachuk trying to skate onto that. McCabe got there first, and Hall will bounce it back in. That went by Murray, and David Camp was on the prowl. But the Senators able to work it out.
You see here Tierney getting a quick little spot. I'm not sure if it's just the little adjustment by DJ Smith and maybe trying to pull back the ice a little bit of Stützle. Tierney gets a top line shift there.
Well, the Family Feud Celebrity Special kicks off January 3rd with Team Alicia Cara against Team Johnny Orlando on CBC at CBC Gym.
It's asking an awful lot for Stützle to go up head-to-head against Austin Matthews each and every shift. And here, as I said, just over halfway through the period, he's down on a different line.
Played with a lot more confidence since moving to center. 4 goals in the last 7 games for Stützle. Simmons rink wide. There's Engvall. Centered, and Stützle back in position defensively to clear that out. You like the idea of him long-term being a center?
I think it's the most challenging position for sure. And hold on here.
Dermott with a chance, shrugged away by Matt Murray.
I'd say no, though. When you get Pinto and Norris back, there's no need. And that's where you can allow him to grow, get confidence, and play the wing, which is a much easier position. But like always, Chris, the injuries just dictate what DJ Smith has to do. Good learning prospect for him, but there's always a few bumps along the way in that.
Highly able to sidestep a check along the board, but it'll be kept in momentarily by Sanford. Mete to Gambrell and wrapped back in behind the Leaf net, where Campbell was challenged there by Watson. Keep it up! And a short side chance for Austin Watson. Valente back to Watson, looking to center with that between the legs pass. And John Tavares takes over for the Leafs and gets them pointed out of the zone. Leaned on there and taken down by Sanford. And it will be another penalty as Tavares looked across and raised his arms. And Sanford will draw his second of the night and the fifth against Ottawa.
Well, it's actually going to be his third of the night, and third. This is just a needless one. It's an extra play, almost a little bit of a, didn't quite get the slew foot in, but got the arm up. And there's just no need for that. You're already down 3-0. You've spent 4 minutes in the penalty box, and now his reaction tells it all. And I'm sure his head coach is feeling very similar type of reaction. It's a little overzealous in the neutral zone on a nothing play.
Yeah, set a look across the ice, didn't he? At the penalized player, the Leafs, who had sustained pressure on their last power play, looking for their first goal with a man advantage tonight. But Ottawa's going to carry it out. Connor Brown goes to work shorthanded. In! Jack Campbell tested there by Brown. What a dangerous shorthanded rush.
The Leafs are 0 for 4 in this game. That's just the second time all year that they've had a game where they've been 0 for 4. An opportunity here on the fifth to try to change that.
Matthews back in. Tavares got crossed up and then dumped Brown. So that's going to be it for the power play. They're 0 for 5 and 34 seconds in. The captain heads off.
Well, for Connor Brown, what a great job of just really being a thorn in the side of this power play. He started it off with a good individual effort that went off the knob of the stick of Campbell. Now he's an aggressive move that turns the puck over, and you can see Tavares with the errant stick right down on the skates, and that creates the penalty for some 4-on-4 hockey for a minute 26.
Tokachuk on this face-off against Matthews. Four skaters aside, Matthews and Marner out there for Toronto. Marner trying to duck away from Mete. Couple of former London Knight teammates battling for the puck. And it's loose for Matthews, back to Hall and across for Sandin. Tkachuk and Batherson, the forwards for the Leafs. And Matthews heads back in, up against Shabbat. Sandin's in deep. Rasmus Sandin tracked by Batherson. Hall will drop it back, and that was nearly picked off by Batherson. Sandin goes for a skate. Teams are changing. Matthews back in. He's got Nylander with him now and got the shot away. Murray stops that. And now out comes Drake Batherson over the line. Tkachuk across one time. And Campbell came across to make that stop. Off Brännström. William McKayev. Here comes TJ Brody again. 2-on-1 along with Dermott in front. And Dermott couldn't knock that down. A 2-on-1 for the Leaf defenseman.
I don't expect that, do you, from Brody and Dermott on a 4-on-4.
I don't expect anything from TJ Brody tonight. Now Tkachuk hands it off and away goes Brown. Over the line with Sanford out of the box. It's an abbreviated power play for Ottawa. They're turned back with just under 20 seconds left in the Tavares penalty. In the late stages of this second period, Ottawa trying to kickstart a comeback with a goal. Shabbat. Around it goes for Mete. Stutzluck trying to knock that one down, but up with it is Kerfoot. And through center, he'll play it in and chip a chase. Leaps back at full strength. Shots on goal, 25-13 Toronto. Off the stick of Watson. There's Piega getting rid of it quickly, and the Leafs are out. And it's Engvall to the Ottawa line with Spezza. Walking in, Spezza tried to go short side. Missed the target, boomerang back into the Leafs zone. Now it's Piega back. Spezza into Ottawa. Ice centered it. It hit Zub and went wide.
Try to cycle it back for Spezza, intercepted by Nick Holden. Out comes Sandin. Bottles up Tierney along the boards. Puck loose for Bishop. And the Newfoundland product works it ahead over the line. And now Bishop picked up there by Sandin as he went to the net. Michael Bunting starts back. Sends it down into the Ottawa zone. Gambrell back there. Chabot able to work it ahead to Odizu. Rink wide. Trying to connect with Logan Shaw. And now Morgan Rielly. Now on a five-game point streak. Off the stick to Bunting and in deep. Around where Marner knocked it down along the boards. Here's Bunting for Matthews out of his reach. And all the way back in the league zone. Campbell will lop that through center, nearly on the tape for Mikheyev. Mikheyev absorbs a hit and stays with the puck. Dermott back to Biega. Back to Dermott. Now it's Biega for Mikheyev. That pass. And Errant went back right to Jack Campbell. 80 seconds left in the second period. Kasha from long range. Turned aside, flipped the hit for Tkachuk, who was poaching at the Leaf line, and now Tierney's on it. To Tkachuk, fires right on, and Campbell's got that with a minute six to go. Shots are 26-14. It's been a big night for TJ Brody, looking for more.
Jake Sanderson was hoping for when the tournament was canceled earlier this week. Pierre Dorion said a few days ago he has an open invitation to join the Sens whenever he wants. All indications are, however, he will return to North Dakota for now as coach there. Brad Berry said this season Sanderson gets to be the guy, the leader of the group. An opportunity to develop the certain qualities you wouldn't otherwise get the chance to. So Ottawa has that going for him, along with some other young players coming their way, especially to think of on a night like this. Chris?
Part of the bright future for the Senators team that was well represented.
And the University of North Dakota has been a big part of it. Yeah. A lot of good youngsters.
There's Nylander going to the net and sending that wide in the final minute of the second period. Tavares tracked by Thompson. Nylander plays it back to the line. Shot goes wide. Picked up by Tavares once again. Thompson ahead for Batherson, and the Senators are up. Tierney with Batherson and Tkachuk in the second period. And now Thompson over the line. Tierney plays it in behind the net. Tkachuk on the hunt for the puck. Tavares back defensively. And Justin Hall comes up with it. For Sandin and out. Look through center and Kerfoot, but Thompson there to knock it away from him. Chabot in the late stages. One last attack here and a good stick check and a lethal counter. Will they have time for Spezza? Across, Nylander, and the horn sounds to deny that last rush. But the Leafs add to their lead in the second on a goal by TJ Brody, who is working on a three-point night. We'll have 32 thoughts coming up in our second intermission with Elliot Friedman and Jeff Merrick on Hockey Night in Canada.
The first ever GMC AT4 lineup. Well, TJ Brody never had a multi-point night with the Leafs before tonight. His last three-point game was January 2019. He's got three so far through two periods. He's doing it at both ends of the ice as well. There's his goal from earlier in the second period. He helped save a goal as well at the other end of the ice. He led an all-defenseman two-on-one as well this evening. Chris, you gave Chatham some love earlier tonight. The mayor of Chatham leading the way for Toronto this evening.
Yes, indeed. He did score in three straight games in his final year in Calgary. But what a splurge tonight. And Craig, you made mention that the Leafs have this three-goal lead without a point from their core four.
That's one of those nights that, you know, doesn't happen that often that they're not the drivers of the offense, but pretty effective game so far through two periods. And for DJ Smith, he needs something happen early here as opposed to penalties
like the first two. Good point by Kelly. We're in different territory here with two teams that haven't played for at least 2 weeks, and so you wonder about the fitness level in the third. Here are the stats after two, and yeah, the Leafs with that big edge in the offensive zone.
They don't always tell the story of a game, but this one really quite does. I mean, the shot attempts, too, are a glaring difference. The offensive zone time and special teams have played such a key role. 8 minutes and 34 seconds of power play time for Toronto, but it's 27 seconds shorthanded. That really was the difference in the game early on.
Check across to Holden and Tierney in front, and Jack Campbell sharp on that redirect by Tierney on the doorstep.
What you like about Campbell is it's been a difficult game for him because he hasn't been all that busy. You can see good hands there by Tkachuk to get it to the outside, but watch his read. He gets right up onto the play, knows that there's going to be a tip coming, doesn't open up any of the middle of his body, and able to not only make the save but get the rebound and the faceoff.
Nylander will step in on this faceoff to the right of Jack Campbell against Stützle. Leafs control and Hall sends it out to center ice. Thomas Chabot on the ice, 16 minutes, 22 seconds through two periods. Morgan Rielly 1 second more to top all Skeeters through the first two periods.
Yeah, that question for Sheldon Keefe about managing ice time. Once you get into the game, you let your players play the way they normally do. And Nylander with 1 day of practice and Rielly have not really looked out of place at all, have they?
It's amazing, Rielly with a 24-minute night coming off all that time away from the rink. Gambrell taken away by Dermott, and now the Leafs work through center, and McKeough will turn back. Watched by Austin Watson, there's Biega. Over the line, Kasha couldn't get loose. Now played deep by Biega. Thompson up the boards, deflected by Sanford. And here's Travis Dermott. McKeough, the intended target of that pass, but that failed to click. Now Kasha to the red line. Stopped up there. And Adam Gaudette will take it away and play it back down into the Leaf zone. Gaudette with a goal in his first game as a member of the Senators against an old team, the Vancouver Canucks. At Vancouver in Seattle coming up in the second half of our Hockey Night in Canada New Year doubleheader as Simmons rolls it to the side of the net. Now back for Rielly, plays it off target. DJ Brody's on the prowl once again in deep. Spezza covering at the point, and that shot off Murray, who I think was screened on the play and didn't track it.
He almost found a way underneath his blocker there. As you're right, his reaction was late to the shot from Spezza.
Brody sends it back to Rielly. Now Matthews. Matthews on a 10-game point streak, 18 points in those 10 games on the line here in this third period. Matthews, some nice work, got it to Marner, in front, bunting, and Murray comes across to prevent the tic-tac-toe goal. And now a chance for Sandin, but he couldn't reach the pass. That would have been highlight reel material. Marner's on the move again, in front of the net, bunting, unable to redirect that. Sandin for Hall to bunting, in front of the net, and Matt Murray says, enough of that.
Well, earlier on, they talked in studio about Matthews being able to turn pucks over to make plays. He had three chances of that one on the board. Got it to Mitch Marner, and there Bunting can't believe he wasn't able to get that one up and over as Murray came sliding across. A tough pass, though, for Bunting as a left-hander trying to just chip it towards the net. Got it a little bit too far to the right, and Murray able to get that leg back and make an excellent save.
Tavares sweeps that faceoff back to Hall. In behind the net. Chabot able to move the puck. Sandin advancing and getting it back to Kerfoot, looking to center it, but Zub is there. Get it in by Hall, and now Chabot sending away Stützle over the line, trying to work his way past Sandin. Zub from the line, knocked down, and the Leafs will counter that pass just out of the reach of Nylander.
And that prevented a two-on-one break for the Leafs. In front, it's Tavares' steal and backhand. Stopped by the glove for Matt Murray.
Tavares was frustrated. His pass to Nylander just went a little bit awry. He made it too quickly, and now that one just gets by him. But Nylander doesn't. He gets there quick enough to negate the icing, then a quick little turnover. And this is one of those little shuttle passes that Shabbat thought he could get to Stützle. And in tight, Tavares unable to find it underneath the arm of Matt Murray.
30th shot on goal for the Leafs tonight. Just shy of the 4-minute mark in the third. Eric Granstrom one hands it ahead. Watson can't take the pass. And now Ottawa will regroup it. Thompson ahead. And that's swung in on the backhand by Sanford. Campbell out of the net to play it. Travis Dermott sidestepped a hit from Gambrell. McKayev up to Kemp, and he'll spin it down behind the Ottawa net. Zach Sanford lost the puck. It's centered in front. McKayev a shot and through the blue paint and out the other way for Gambrell. One extra pass there, too, as Spezza's on it. Here's Jason Spezza working his way in, but can't get by Lassie Thompson.
I don't think Kashev was expecting that pass from McKayev, was he? He was right on the doorstep.
There's Riley across. Engvall fires that. Murray holds on.
Well, we saw those stats of offensive zone time and shot attempts, and this third period has been very much the same. A little sloppy play down low as Sanford loses the puck. Good forecheck by Kemp, and just that quick reaction. McKayev shuttle pass kind of handcuffed Kasha a little bit, and then here on the last one, tough angle there as Engvall tried to slide one past Murray, and he's able to hold on.
Leafs have won 73% of the draws tonight. And Spezza wins another away from Tierney. Brody, Engvall, shot wide with traffic heavy in front of Murray. And now Batherson ahead for Tkachuk. That one flipped in front, and Tierney unable to skate onto that. The Leafs will counter as Wayne Simmonds plays it off his skate. And bumps it down into the Ottawa zone. Mete around the boards. There's Batherson handing it off to Shabbat, and a hit for Tierney. Trying to bump the slump, Tierney for Shabbat, and Engvall covering him and taking it away. Matthews pass intercepted by Batherson, but Matthews stepped back in to get it to Riley, who just flips it down the ice. It's going to be an icing call against Toronto. Find out what growing up was like for Mark Critch from This Hour's 22 Minutes, Son of a Critch, a new CBC original comedy coming this January to CBC and CBC Jam.
Chris, you mentioned the faceoffs. The Leafs, the second best faceoff team in the league. And for this kind of play, icing, you win the draw, you got some tired bodies, and you hope you can make a change. And that's exactly what Austin Matthews is able to do to get some fresh troops out there.
Matthews now 9-3 on the night. Bunting for Marner. Nick Holden is there. Sandin moves it ahead. Bunting on the backhand drops it back down into the Ottawa zone. Matthews leaning on Holden. Bunting there trying to pry it loose. Matthews looking to center, but Zub there to deny that. Marner holds the zone, but not for long. As out came Stützle, he lost the puck, and Marner back for Matthews. Across for Sandin. Leafs blue line's been jumping all night. Sandin takes a long look. Back to Hall and Marner. Marner from long range, and the rebound got past Bunting. And Connor Brown across ice for Zub, wants to get off. And got some help from Stützle to get it down into the Leaf zone.
You know, so often you listen to Sheldon Keefe talk about puck possession as such an important part of the Leafs' offensive game. But what it does, too, is it helps your defensive game. This has been a perfect example. Just 14 shots on goal, haven't given up anything, but so much of it has been because of the offensive puck possession that the Leafs have been able to establish.
So we're just shy of the 7-minute mark in the third on New Year's night in Toronto.
going on tonight in Minnesota. Blues lead the Wild 6-2 in that one. It was 5 years ago today. They went outdoors at BMO Field here in downtown Toronto. Auston Matthews, 2 goals in that one. The hero in overtime, but they haven't needed his offense here so far tonight as Toronto leads it 3-0, Chris.
Leafs have won 5 of their last 6 on New Year's Day. Last win for the Senators on this date was back in 2004. Patrick Laliem, shutout, and Peter Schaefer scoring in a 1-0 win over the New York Islanders. From the draw, scramble with a couple of players hitting the deck, including Kerfoot. Up with the puck is Clark Bishop. He'll drop it in, and there's a backhand by Logan Shaw that Campbell stops. And it's played back to Thompson, and his shot is blocked and ricochets back through center. Thompson looking for his first NHL goal. Thought he had it earlier this year against Colorado, only to find out it had been tipped by Zach Sanford as Campbell holds on to that.
Well, with a quiet building, you could hear all the yelling off the faceoff. And what it was Kerfoot falls down here. He plays the puck with his hand. If he was the centerman, that would be a penalty. And the Ottawa Senators wanted a call there, but it was Tavares who was the center iceman. Now as a winger, he's just coming in, so it's not the same rules. And Kerfoot just trying to keep the puck alive offensively gets a little bit of a break there. Smart play, though.
Tierney and Campbell on that draw. The Leafs are out. And here's Kasha playing it past Shabbat and behind the net. Campbell almost stole another, but now Tkachuk steering it ahead. And there's Batherson on the move. There's Batherson kicking it loose. Tierney to Shabbat at the line. Tierney back to Shabbat. Fires right on. That will stick to Campbell.
Desjardins, a proud part of communities, a proud fan of hockey wherever it's played.
Well, Thomas Chabot just trying to get the shooting lane by sliding across. Kasha is a little late, but look at the positioning in front. Good box out by Morgan Riley. Batherson unable to get in the eyes of Campbell, and an easy save.
Stutzla to Chabot at the line, and there's another long-range Chabot shot stopped by Jack Campbell.
You know, you look at the excellence of Campbell this year. He's got 15 wins on the year, and 10 of those wins he's allowed one goal against or less. Just incredible run here, and since January 1 of a year ago, those numbers are pretty darn impressive. And one of the reasons why the confidence of this team has been able to stay so high, knowing each and every night you're going to get a good performance by number 36.
Beat the Senators in his first start against Ottawa this year, and then had to come in relief of Peter Mrazek, and was 10 for 10 in a loss in Ottawa. And there is Mrazek who backs up tonight, and all the time off, you expect that he's back in full health.
You know what is good for me, though, his worst stretch was an 0-2-1 start. He started 2-2-1 to begin the season, did Campbell. But he hasn't lost back-to-back games since October 25th, 17 games. And if you allow your team to avoid any kind of losing streaks, that's what keeps the pressure going. And that's what Campbell's been able to provide for his team.
Wayne Simmonds digging in on that right side. Soon for Ottawa to hold in, hopped over his stick. And now Batherson on the move at center with Tkachuk breaking to the net. That one flipped high and up onto the screen.
Well, for DJ Smith, you know you've got some injuries. We talked about the loss of Norris, one of your key centermen, so you got to move players like Tierney and Stutzla up. But you just got to get through these difficult, rough points. And I mentioned coming in 5-2-1, they had a little good run going before the stoppage of 13 days, and here they just haven't been able to get any offense going whatsoever.
Thompson steers it behind the net. Connor Brown looks for Brännström. Eric Brännström shot sails wide. After it is Stutzla along with Brown. Stutzla unable to get loose. First NHL goal for the sophomore against Toronto. Now Marner over the line, Bunting cutting to the net. Here's Matthews, and he just missed. One of his best looks of the night, knocks it down. But Brown able to recover for Ottawa.
And he knew it, Chris. He looked skyward. He couldn't believe he missed that one. He was set up coming from his left to right. Thought he had top corner picked and just got a little high wide.
Be the example of 18-day rust.
Yep.
Those have been going in over the last 10 games, 13 of them. As mentioned, on a 60-goal pace coming into this game tonight. Watson takes it away from Tavares. That shot is blocked in front, loose. And Watson checked by Tavares. The puck comes out to center where Nylander will flip it down into the Senators' zone past the 10-minute mark of the third. Tavares goes down in the corner, has to retrieve his stick. Nylander's got the puck. William Nylander back across, Biega shooting, and Matt Murray has that.
Auston Matthews has 5 goals behind Leon Draisaitl. He's got a 10-game scoring streak going, looking to make it 11. This one just a little too high wide. He couldn't believe it. Quick little wrister gets away from him, and he looks skyward in disbelief.
Seemed to work for number 34 because he scored 10 goals in 7 games in December. But we noticed after the last miss that the stash is back.
It is. And, you know, amazingly, he was on a 3-game goal scoring streak and continued to score a hat trick that first game on December 1st and has scored in 6 of 7 since then. If he doesn't score tonight, does it come off tomorrow? I don't know.
He's not going to score every night, although it's felt like it of late. With 19 goals in the last 21 games. Mete up for Batherson, who kicked it loose for Shabbat. Batherson with 16 points in his last 10 for Ottawa, trying to get something going offensively here as he moves it for Tkachuk. And that's down into the Leaf zone with just over 9 minutes to go. Up ahead, McKeever tied up there by Zub. William McKeever with 6 shots on goal tonight. Brody idles as the Leafs complete a change. Artem Zub off the boards, out of the reach of Connor Brown, but there's the speedy Formanton in, trying to center him. Jason Spezza back defensively, gave it away, and Campbell bails out the veteran on that stop on a point-blank shot by Formanton.
Well, there haven't been too many times that Campbell's had to bail anyone out. It's been a pretty neat and tidy game in the defensive zone. Spezza, just a dangerous pass trying to go across crease, but look at a Campbell's reaction coming flying out. Get a sorry about that, partner. And Campbell gives, as he typically does, a little tap to the shin pads as well.
Formanton's had a couple of chances in this game. DJ Brody robbing him once, and now Campbell with that stop. Here's Thompson, that pass off a Leaf leg, and Matthews bounced off a check from Stützle. Flipped ahead for Bunting. Race for it, and Ottawa wins the race to get the icing call.
Providing competitive odds on all sports, Sports Interaction is Canada's sports book.
So 8:08 left here in the third period. Senators will not play at home. Next home schedule date, January the 18th, so you've got to find a way to break through on the road. That Tkachuk shot out of play.
Yeah, it doesn't get any easier, does it? And it's just the adjustments that you're going to have to make, the delay of the home games, try to allow some fans in the stands. Right now, you just need to try to find some kind of spark. You never know how long it's going to take, and as we've talked before, Chris, what will tomorrow bring? Any new COVID cases? might change things on a daily basis.
You mentioned it seems strange. This is the healthiest the Leafs have been all year. Boy, the case count in Montreal has climbed. Calgary was hit hard. Ottawa now in the midst of a stretch of multiple cases.
Well, now for the Leafs, you've already had, what, 15 players who have already had it. So it's almost like the worst case has kind of gone by. And now as they continue to get a little healthier, we hope there won't be the disruptions in their locker room.
Hall and Sandin have appeared together tonight. The pass on the left side for Simmons. He tracks that down in the Ottawa zone. Engvall crashing in there as well as Mete trying to take it away, and Watson knocks his man down. Thompson spun around by Simmons, and Ottawa's away with the puck. Mete ahead, good pass for Gambrell. Here's Gambrell shifting gears in the Leaf zone and then gets knocked down by Biega. Lead feed for Engvall is too far. It's an icing call against Toronto.
Yeah, just an errant play there by Spezza, but we've mentioned the faceoff prowess, and it just really hasn't been a problem. They've had a few times with some tired bodies that they've had the icings, but 70% they continue on there. It becomes less of a problem until Ottawa can find a way to start winning some draws and keep the pressure on. You get another one draw and alleviate that pressure. And ice it again.
Simmons bounces it down. Not quite enough as Zoo picks it up about a foot short of the goal line, and away he goes. Martin Zoo swings it around the far side. Kerfoot cuts that off. A pass for Dermott, and ahead it goes. It's a breakaway for William. Nylander scores! One for the core four, and it is 4-0 for Toronto.
Now what a play by William Nylander in anticipation of this breakout. I mean, you get a dump in, he's on the sideboard, watch the middle of the ice. You make one good outlet pass, he's gone, a little shuffle with his feet. Now he's got so much speed that speed just simply takes Murray's movement right out of the equation. No hesitation at all, keeps his legs moving, and a quick, determined play. Murray's going to have to slide back so quickly to try to make that save. There's the high fives of the very few fans we do have in there, but Superfan gets his moment. And Nylander with the point back, just a great pass up the middle, but excellent move with all kinds of speed to make that one possible.
Though it's the 14th of the season for William Nylander.
There's Batherson off the faceoff. He got the stick right up, so another needless penalty here. It's been a problem for DJ Smith the beginning of both periods, and here Batherson just with the errant stick gives a power play, which will start with the second unit another opportunity.
For five, no shortage of chances on the power play. Ottawa turns them back. So the Senators now have killed 24 of their last 25 shorthanded. Sandin on the move. Over the line it goes. Kasha cuts to his backhand, drops it back for Spezza. Rasmus Sandin on the take for Bunting, and Spezza knocked off his stick, and Formanton gets a clear.
Another guy who's really taken advantage of opportunity has been Rasmus Sandin. He's been given the opportunity on the second power play and at times the first. But with Jake Muzzin out in the pairing tonight, he's been really effective at both ends.
Great pass by Spezza, looking for return feed. That was broken up. Sandin, Mikheyev. And here is Jason Spezza, winds and fires. And the state out scores. Ilya Mikheyev. His second of the night, and the Leafs break through on the power play.
You know, this is one of those payoffs, and I think just a great move by Sheldon Keefe. Look at the reaction. You know, it's about building a team. You got a power play that hasn't been working all night. 0 for 5 coming in. Give the second unit the first chance, and they take full advantage of it. Shot off the side of the net. Good response by Kasha. No chance at all for Murray, and the puck has been finding Mikheyev all night long, and here, a gaping wide open net off of a nice pass from behind, and smiles all around. But from a head coach, that's a good feel. You know you need the two units going at critical times, and there was a great example of giving them the opportunity, and they paid it off.
Well, the adversity McKay had gone through this year, the broken thumb. First game, and not until 18 days ago in Edmonton, and now he's got two goals in two games this year. Seven shots on goal to match a career best. Here, Simmons trying to come out in front. And it's Engvall shooting. That's up off the shoulder of Murray. Under five left here in the third. And the Leafs up by four as McKay has a pair.
If you're Ottawa, you know, how do you make judgment on Matt Murray here, too? This has been a night. Look at the shots, 37-21. His first game back, all the adversity he's faced, but another difficult position for him.
Anderson kicked away by Campbell. Marner up with the rebound, had some trouble with it, but Travis Dermott gets it out of harm's way to the Ottawa line. So the first career two-goal game for Ilya Mikheyev. Get the power play goal to extend their streak in that department to seven games. Tierney with the pass for Tkachuk off the boards and out. Now Marner up for Matthews. Slick pass to Marner with a backhand across the goal mouth. And Brady Tkachuk gets rid of it back into the lead zone. Shots now 37-22 Toronto. Matthews tied up at center. Nick Holden after it. Warrington can't get it past Hall. And now Kerfoot over the line. Chips it off the board. Can't catch up to it as Holden in front of his own net. And Connor Brown takes a look. That long pass off the boards for Warrington on a set play to help strike the speedy winger. Now Sandin on the tape for Tavares. John Tavares turned back by Zoo. Hands it off to Nylander. Nylander now on a six-game point streak, scores again. William Nylander has two in the third.
You could just see the faces on the bench. One team's got life. This has been just a ratcheted up game as the offenses continue to click the quick passes. This is another excellent pass by Rasmus Sandin that spreads the Ottawa Senators out. Nice little cyclic play. Now Tavares goes back to the middle, draws two guys with him. And for Matt Murray, you saw there, he had no idea where that puck was. Look at all the bodies in front. A couple of flybys as Mikheyev right in his eyes. Two of his own players for Murray screening him as well.
Here's Tierney. Tierney with a shot, knocked down, rebound. He took a whack at it, but played away, and the Leafs are out. Just can't get along the boards at the Ottawa line. 15 goals now on the season for Nylander. He said he spent most of his time in protocol playing Call of Duty, but has answered the call here in the third period tonight. Oh, the video games help these guys with the reaction time.
That seems so.
Away goes Formanton. And he is bumped there by Biega. Gambrell on the near side, cycles it back for Brown. Alex Biega's on it, and he'll send it through center, right on Matt Murray. 6-0 Maple Leafs. Second time they hit a half dozen, and we've got a penalty coming up against Toronto. With a minute 37 to go, Justin Hall will head off.
Well, the puck's up in the air, so Hall going after it, ends up missing the puck, gets the cross check right in the jaw of Brown. Brown missed it as he was trying to pop that one by the defender, instead draws the penalty. And Chris, now you're just defending for your goaltender here if you're the Leafs. The late power play, don't give him anything here. And for Ottawa, gotta try something positive out of what's been a disappointing first game back.
Third time with six goals. They scored 8 against Colorado, 6 against LA earlier this year. Matherson in front. Kachuk just missed on the tip. And the Leafs are up shorthanded, where they have scored twice this year in this game in the first period. On the goals by Hall and Mikheyev that set the tone for the night. Thomas Chabot gets it back from Brown, drops to Kachuk, looking for Brown. Logan Riley there defensively. Kemp comes back, but Kachuk battling along the boards, hits the deck, and now Kemp with a chance to clear, and does.
You know, another great example of just Campbell reading the play. You got to know where the threat is. The shot's coming from his left, but he knows he's got Kachuk to his right, and he does a great job of bringing his body out and closing the gap so the tip doesn't have any chance of getting by him.
40 seconds left as Batherson brings the power play back in. Checked by Kerfoot. And away goes Mikheyev. He's got two. Got it to Kerfoot. And Matt Murray with the save. And just under a half minute to go.
Well, almost the third shorthanded goal of the game. But it came off a great save by Campbell. As I said, especially on power plays, you have to respect the shot from Batherson. But look at him slide across. Gets the not only the pad down low, but the blocker there. Now you get a turnover. Good job of taking to the outside, not allowing Mikheyev to get a clear lane as Thompson was able to cut him off, and then not much of a chance there for Kerfoot as Murray makes the save.
Now Formanton trying to cut in, turn back against Biega. Lassie Thompson off Engvall and out. Kerfoot with a three-assist night, and he hits 100 career assists on this night. Watson back. Brännström leaned on by Mikheyev. Dying seconds. Engvall is going to get a chance to clear it and fire it down the ice. Jack Campbell has posted his fourth shutout of the season and his eighth of his career. We've got a little discussion going on down in the Leaf zone as New Year's greetings are being exchanged.
You know, so much talk about the business side of the Leafs deciding to play these games Saturday and Wednesday, and the hockey side maybe took precedent, I think, and rightly so. Get back in the rhythm of your game. A frustrating night for the Ottawa Senators, but an overall neat and tidy game for the Maple Leafs.
The Leafs host the 6-0 shutout. They've got Edmonton Wednesday. We'll be back with more on Hockey Night in Canada.